Yeah, that hold on tight. Ooh, that hold on tight. Them lips won't let me go. No, baby. Holding back your faces up with me.
All graduating seniors, please sign your name. Mr. Benjamin had the sheet. If you're a graduating senior, can you sign your name on the sheet? Last name, first name. The sheet's over there somewhere. Where's the graduating senior sheet? Mr. Chris, you're a graduating senior. Sign your name.
No, no, I try to maintain. So don't mind if I turn away. Then hold on tight. Ooh, then hold on tight. Them lips won't let me go.
Right, let's do our usual current events, and let's see. I'll show a clip. Okay. All right. Who wants to volunteer to take the two things around and walk around? Who wants to volunteer? Two people. All right. Thank you, Miss Mallory. Just one.
Testing. One, two. Testing. Oh shoot. Does this work? Testing. Can you test?
Hello. Test. Oh, does it work?
And give that to someone else too. All right.
All right, guys, let's do, are we another taker? Another taker? All right, over there. Thank you. Okay, let's do current events, guys. What's going on in our neighborhood? Current events. Mr. Benjamin, over there. Mr. Holler. Run over. Thank you.
Thank you. I think I'm not the only person who knows about this, but I'll be the first one to bring it up about Obama bringing home our last troop, or our last soldier that was being held captive. And I just kind of watched that whole story and saw the father grow the beard and like learn the language. And I just thought it was interesting that he kind of created an image for himself that made it easier to basically negotiate with the Taliban.
Oh, great, Mr. Benjamin. Have you guys heard about that? They traded for Taliban for one soldier?
Five.
And then did you guys hear about the controversy?
Yeah.
Tell us about it.
Well, I think I heard about it. basically, these five Taliban, they were highly ranked. They're high generals. And there's this kind of fear that they're going to go back and kind of create terrorism or inflict terrorism. So if anybody knows any further details, that's kind of like the gist that I got of it.
It was actually, is this on? It was actually, anyways, it was actually, the controversy was the fact that he basically left his post and then five other people in the military died because he left. Yeah. So actually, like, a lot of people are really pissed off. First off, that we negotiated with terrorists, which is something we're supposed to not do, but also because, and to a lot of other soldiers' minds, he wasn't worth it because he's the reason that a lot of people died because he just left. It wasn't like he was actually, like, taken. He did not want to be a soldier. He did not approve of America. So that's actually the controversy. But
anything else? Anyone else for current events? Mr. Aaron, anything? Current events? Yes, go ahead.
I just read this like a couple hours ago, but this man shot his 9-month-old girlfriend. He says it was an accident, but I mean 9-month pregnant girlfriend. Sorry. So she was 9 months pregnant, and then he shot her, and then he says it was an accident, like they were in an argument or whatever. But she was able to give birth to the baby, but she died after that. So. He said, like, he went to go show his girlfriend his broken gun, and it went off on her. So, yeah.
Thank
Have you heard of this Yes All Women thing, the hashtag? Yes All Women? Have you heard of it?
I have heard of Yes.
Okay. That's it.
Okay, right, there's a Twitter thing, right, about the
Twitter. The woman who started it is actually requesting to not use it because she's been getting so many death threats from
men. Oh, wow. Okay.
What is it?
Can you tell us about it?
So basically, hashtag Yes All Woman was a response to the Santa Barbara shooting. It was basically because a lot of men got pissed off that they said it was a misogynistic issue, and so they put hashtag Not All Men. And so Yes All Women was a response to that, because basically not all men, I guess, harass women, but all women have basically been harassed by men. And so that was basically a response, and then she decided, the woman who created it kept getting death threats. So you're supposed to use, like, hashtag every woman or something like that.
Excellent. Thank you. Anyone else back there? Any kind of events back there? Or the middle?
All right. So raise your hand if you're a graduating senior. Who's a graduating senior? All right. All right. Where's my paper? Where's my paper? Okay. All right, where's my paper? Everyone, graduate seniors, did you all write your name on the sheet? There's a sheet now that's going around, and it's requesting, if you're a graduating senior, you're in a week from now, you're going to walk, and your parents are, you kind of made your parent visit. Can you sign your name on the sheet? So where's the sheet? All right, has everyone signed it? No, okay, can you guys do that quickly? Look surprised. Okay, but let's go through the current events. Let's do awkward black girl, and then we might have a surprise for the graduating seniors. Okay, but shh. Okay, all right. We're Miss Ashley, season 2, episode 2.
So you had another sleepover with White Jay, and nothing happened. OMG, are you in the sixth grade? No. You're worse than a sixth grader. My 13-year-old student asked me where she could find birth control. Jay, you're a grown-ass woman. What's the big deal?
I have the worst track record in relationship history.
No, that award goes to Halle Berry.
It's like sex is the kiss of death for me.
It doesn't have to be, Jay. I know what this is. This is advanced rejection displacement syndrome with additional symptoms of intercourse anxiety. You're afraid of failure, Jay. And you're using the sex as an excuse to keep some distance between you and White Jay to protect yourself.
You don't know my life, Cece. Or does she?
White Jay isn't D. How do you know this? What he's even thinking?
He definitely was. You weren't there.
Okay, walk me through it.
So I come in, and it's all dark.
Like serial killer dark?
No, there were candles. So, like, Shakespearean dark.
What did he say?
Jay, it's a very special night tonight. You know, it's been 3 weeks, and,
it's time for you ladies to get back to work. Story time is for children, and you're not children, are you ladies?
Do I really have to answer that?
No, Jesus.
That's right, you are not. I expect to see you both in the staff meeting in the next few minutes.
I'm convinced my boss uses intense eye contact as a weapon. It's uncomfortable.
Yesterday, I jumped ahead of myself. I realized that you cannot introduce teffort when the effort is lacking. I'm very disappointed in you. And by you, I mean everyone. I'm here to play the tape.
Hi, my name is Sister Mary, and the Lord ordained me to help you lose that belly fat. We have a hello?
You recorded my call? That's just
necessary. For had I not, I would have never have known how much guidance you need. This is a business, not a Jehovah hotline.
Hello? What? Who is this?
My name is Darius.
Could you turn it up? I think the volume's low.
Is this a prank call? What's happening?
Weight loss.
Okay, I'll buy some pills.
Now, while this call bizarrely resulted in a sale, this is atypical of your calls, Darius. You have the most hang-ups within a 5-second period.
I mean, there's a certain method to my madness.
Save your excuses for later. Amir, continue.
Hi, I'm calling from Gutbusters to tell you about our new big solution.
Hey, Patty. I've been waiting all day for your call.
This is a violation of privacy.
Sorry, Boopy. We had a long team meeting this morning.
What are you wearing?
Boy, stop. You know I'm at work. So, a bra, panties, tissues.
Oh. Turn it off! Yes, please, turn it off!
Team, this is unacceptable. Yay, please come up here.
Did I do something wrong? This Mexi Nick is like a principal.
Please demonstrate the proper Gutbusters phone approach.
Oh, I don't feel comfortable.
Now, nonsense. You're among peers. Now pretend I'm a potential customer. Remember to establish intimacy.
Hi. Hi, Jesus. How are you doing today?
Oh, I'm fine. Thank you. Who is this?
This is Jay, your friendly gut coach.
No, more energy. I don't believe you.
I'd love to introduce you to our new big solution.
Yay, put some oomph in it. It's bland.
Oh, excellent. Thank you.
I just want you to be the best you can be.
Very unattractive. I don't want anything from you. Please, hang up.
Unattractive? Did that really just happen?
This is something we'll be working on over the next week. We have a lot of work ahead of us. Let's not waste any more time. Everyone take lunch.
If I can't even be appealing to obese bulimics, how will YJ stick around?
Not all relationships are built on a third date rule. You have time. You have nothing to feel insecure about.
Except that you suck at everything.
3 dates? Is that how the pagans do it? Honey, you're not gonna keep a man if you don't wait until marriage.
You sure didn't wait with Tyreek.
That's when I was Dolores, motherfucker.
Look, everybody knows if you make a man wait, that's the fastest way to get what you want.
Love?
Money.
Well, me, myself, personally, I say if the chemistry is right, you ain't gotta keep it tight. Day one, week one, tops.
Bitch, that's why you're sick.
I'd say 6 months.
I'm the only one in this group that really knows how to cut it down. Jay, when you're ready, you'll know. Don't force it.
Cece's right. I like him. He likes me. What am I being such a pansy about?
Hey, wanna come over?
I'm a grown-ass woman. It's time to start acting like one.
Okay, see you soon.
Hey, are you hungry? For this punani? Beyonce wouldn't do that. Boobies, 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 boobies. Hey, are you hot in here? Cause I checked the temperature and it's 69 degrees. You're so ready. Boobies, boobies. Almost there? What would 90s Nia Long do? white people listen to when they have sex? Taylor Swift? Michael Bolton? Eminem. There's no bigger turnoff than family.
Great. We're at the end of our class, so I hope you will continue watching it by yourself. It was voted number one series by the world, the globe. Okay, so, and all right, guys, it's a surprise today. Where's my graduating seniors? Raise your hand again. All right, I'm going to call each of you down, and I want everyone to clap for each of them, because this is a huge, momentous accomplishment. In 1 week, their family and friends are going to come to celebrate them, so why don't we celebrate in our class as well? This is, hold on. Okay. Mr. Reggie, you're so surprised, right? Okay. Okay, so surprise, yes. Okay, so we're going to celebrate you in our class as well, because you've learned a lot about women's studies, and you've looked about women all over the world, global women, right? Comfort women, Thai sex slaves, proletariat, Russian women, right? And sometimes accomplishment is just to survive the next day, right? To not commit suicide, right? But our graduate seniors, more uplifting. It's a different type of accomplishment, right? You want to live the next day. So I think that in the future, you're going to have ups and downs, right? Because your generation is not like this, or neither was mine. It's going to be like this, 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 and then this, and then this, and then, right? So you have to make your own way. But I hope you'll remember our class as, and try to kind of be inspired that some people, just to get to the next day is a form of survival, right? And it's kind of huge, okay? Mr. Aaron, is he here? Mr. Aaron's not here. Darn it, Mr. Aaron's not here. Okay, he's also a graduate senior. All right, let's call the names out. Graduate seniors, come on down. Maybe you guys can give us, where's the other one? Maybe you can give us some advice to the rest of people who want to be you, okay? Give us, like, one advice if you can, okay? All right, I'm going to call you guys out. Come on down. Okay. Has everyone written in, graduate seniors? Everyone's written your name? All right. Adriana Franco, let's give her a hand. Come on down. Okay. Give us some advice.
Enjoy every moment, because it's going to go by quick.
It's over. She has 1 week. It's done. All right. You're awesome. All right. All right. If you can, well, you're gonna help pass it out, but you're also going to get one and all these things. So I'll show her here so we can celebrate you. Okay. All right. Benjamin. Mr. Benjamin. Let's give him a hand. Give us some advice.
Whatever you want in life, whatever your goal is, want it more than you want to breathe, because then you'll just be driven to get that shit. So, yeah.
Okay. All right. Thank you. All right. Well, give us the next one. Is it Gabriella Esponza? I can't read this. It's Barza? Gabriella? Is that Gabriella? Is that Esparza? Congratulations. Give us some advice. You're going to get something. You don't have to.
Okay, I just say as long as you guys try your best, you guys will get there. Doesn't matter how long, though.
All right, doesn't matter how long. Keep going. All right, Gabriella Espinoza. Gabriella Espinoza. Okay, let's give her a hand. All right. Here, okay. All right.
Basically, just stay focused and
stay focused. School. All right, excellent. Okay. Natalie Herrera. Herrera? Herrera? Excuse me. All right. Congratulations. Okay.
Don't procrastinate.
That's great advice. That's great advice. Thank you. Okay. All right. Zoom Lima Zamora. Is that I'm saying correctly, or Zoom Lima? All right. Congratulations.
Basically, no matter how difficult it gets, don't give up on what you really want to do.
Excellent. Neva Lu. Right. Congratulations.
Just make the most of your time here, but don't slack off too much.
Okay, great. Azel Akarbanaten? Is it Azel? Great. Come on down. Okay. We're 1/4 down the list. Okay. And next is Renee. So Renee, you're gonna come next. Then Jessica.
Just take your time in college. Don't rush anything because you want to get good grades and yeah, to raise your GPA.
Okay, great. All right, thank you. All right, and I'm sorry, full name?
Renee Caballero.
Thank you, Renee.
Just enjoy your time here and join as many programs as you can.
Join programs. All right, excellent. Jessica Tazoom. Jessica, and right after Jessica, Millie Wang. Millie Wang, you're next. Kathy, who you're next after her. Your shirt.
Thanks. I would just say enjoy the moment while you can.
All right, excellent. Millie Wang, Catherine Hu, Taylor Banks after, Darcy Tong after.
Yes. I would say don't procrastinate either.
Don't procrastinate. Okay, thank you. Millie, congratulations. Catherine Hu. All right. After Taylor Banks, Darcy, and then Paola. All right, yes.
I guess make every moment of every day count and take the word lazy out of your vocabulary.
Take the word lazy. All right. Congratulations. Okay. Go ahead.
I guess my advice would be to make every day important or make every day matter. There's teachable moments within every day. So if you just, even if you don't really like school, just take it as a learning experience.
Yes. And, yeah, thank you. Congratulations. And say your name.
Oh, my name is Darcy. I would just say stay involved and visit your teacher's office hours so it's easier to get letter rides.
Excellent.
Paola? Yes. I would say to, like, get out of your comfort zone because it's, like, the best place to, like, try new things.
Excellent. Thank you. Cynthia, Ken Zhao, Emerald, Mary, Charles Ruiz, come on down. Our seniors. Congratulations.
My advice would be to manage your time, know when to party, and then when to hit the books.
Great time. Like for now, it'd be good to study right now. Yes.
I would say to cherish every moment you have here because you won't realize the value of it until it becomes a memory.
It's going to be a memory. 1 week, guys. Excellent.
I would say love what you do and don't be motivated by money.
Excellent. Thank you. Congratulations.
So just believe in yourself.
Excellent. All right. Okay.
I would just say do what makes you happy because your happiness is all that matters.
Great advice. Congratulations. Okay. Sunwoo, Raphael, Justin, V, Alan, Cameron, come on down. Congratulations. What would you like to tell us?
Enjoy every moment because time flies.
It does. Okay. Guys, over here, he's going to pass you the mic, so give us some advice. And congratulations.
What's up, guys?
Okay.
Don't forget to have a little bit of fun besides studying too much.
Okay. I was just going to say, life is tough, but... Just keep moving forward and learn from it.
Great. Congratulations. congratulations.
I'd say just enjoy your time here because looking for jobs suck.
Yes, I agree.
Don't judge a book by its cover.
Excellent, thank you.
Just study hard.
Great, okay, is that Cameron? Yes, okay, and can I have Maria, Derek, Chris, Brianna, Tahir, Linda, and I'm gonna mangle this, Chiamaka? Okay. All right, come on, congratulations, guys, congratulations. The 1%, go ahead, congratulations, go ahead.
I just want to say that we're always becoming.
Excellent.
If you guys are going to procrastinate, do it well.
Stay focused and go to class.
Just take advantage of every opportunity you can.
Don't be afraid to ask for help when you need it.
Great.
Take your time here and enjoy it because it does go by really, 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 really fast.
All right, guys, let's give a big hand for the 1% of the globe. 1% of the globe. You guys are awesome, okay? All right, 1% of the globe, okay? All right, guys, we're going to have a little party, okay, a little snack party. So I guess you can help us out by just grab some food and take it with you and then pass it out to the rest, okay? So grab a box, open it, and take it with you. You can open that box inside their boxes, so pass it out to all your fellow students, yeah. Oh, sorry, excuse me, sorry. There's a lot of there. Yeah, take it out and take it out with you and go back to where you're sitting and spread it out. Just take it back to where you're sitting and spread it, okay? Right, thank you. Just open it and spread it to where you are sitting. I think that will effectively, everyone will get something, okay? So you all stay everywhere. Yeah, so rip it open. Okay. All these boxes, so take one out and take it to everyone where you're sitting. Open all the boxes.
What is this?
It's a party for you guys.
No, I mean, what are those?
The chocolates. Okay.
You want it?
Yeah. Thank you. And then take it when you're ready. Take it. Whoa. Take it where you're sitting and open it and give it to everyone around you. Did we miss any graduating seniors? Did we miss anyone? Did we miss any 1%ers? Okay. All trash, just give it back to me here. All the trash, we don't make any, spit it back here. Okay. All right. 1%ers, we want to congratulate you. Your family's coming, I know, but we're kind of like your family too, so. Okay. You guys are awesome. Okay. All right. All right. Hey, I don't know why this is here. Trash is here. I'll take it out later. Right. Okay. Everyone should get one. So. I guess enough for two, so I'm not taking anything home, so you're taking it all, okay. Yes, thank you. Why is this turned off? How did this happen?
How did they cut the cake?
Is it nice? It's a cookie.
Figure it out.
It's Chiamaca. It's up to you.
Pencil.
You're to hand and then. Okay. Why is this turned off? Why is this turned off? Okay. Why is it on this? It should be here. So someone must have turned it off. It was on when you left. Why is this on? Okay. I don't know why it's.
Some people say they won't break you. Time to feel looking for love, for love, for love. Hoping I can help, for love, for love. But I can't say from the top, from the off of my head.
Let's get out. It's kind of hard not to get stressed out.
All right, you're very talented. Let's give him a hand, guys. Here's Benjamin. All right, excellent. Thank you. Okay. All right, guys, let's switch really quick to Pokemon, okay? So we went last class. We talked about neither gender, people who are not gendered, right? They're not men or not women, okay? Now we're going to talk about your childhood with ambiguous gender. Who's heard of this thing called Pokemon? Okay. International students, Mr. Christopher, you've never heard of Pokemon? Okay, you're a huge fan. Who has never heard of Pokemon? All right, well, Pokemon, people like to study it, and there's actually a whole book on Pokemon, is that it influenced you because it's not a gender as well. Mr. Christopher, Ms. Ashley, did you know that as kids? Okay. Okay, it didn't matter what gender you are, right? Because most, okay. All right, so guys, you guys are young, but you'll have to tell me what Pokemon generation you are, okay? Because there's, okay. So, theme song, which one? You got to tell me. Theme song.
I want
to
be the very best.
Okay, so theme song, there's many theme songs. Which one? There's many generations. This one, okay. I don't know, okay.
I wanna be the very best, like no one ever was. To catch them is my real test, to train them is my cause. I will travel across the land, searching far and wide. Need Pokemon to understand the power that's inside.
Pokemon, gotta catch them all.
It's me.
Our international students, you guys have heard of this, right? Mr. Rami, have you heard of Pokemon? So you grew up with Pokemon too, right? All right, okay. All right, so Pokemon, we're moving from many thousands of gender theories last class, right? To non-gender, which is hedras, not women or men. Now we're going to do inanimate objects that you grew up with, right? That are non-gendered, okay? So there's an anthropology book quite famous, and I actually teach the whole book in my other class, but we're just going to do, we're going to do a clip, okay? All right, so only one chapter. All right, so everyone, can I have a guest or student to read this, okay? Keep it out there. This Melody will just ask you the whole thing. Sure, the whole thing, you two just, okay. Awesome. All right.
Pokemon was created by a Japanese man named Satoshi Tajiri. Thank you. He wanted to recreate his childhood excitement of capturing insects. Originally 151 Pokemon, first Game Boy, 1996. 1997 Pokemon TV show created, 1998 hits USA. Best Saturday morning TV show ever.
All right. Did you all know that Pokemon is from Japan?
Yes.
So you knew that you're actually absorbing Japanese cultural product, right? It's a Japanese product, right? That's their imagination.
Yes.
They have a lot of spiritual beliefs of animals that have no gender. Did you think about that?
Yeah.
Okay. Kind of Eastern religions, right? Kind of the hedras. There are in other cultures, other religions, there are lots of figures in Buddhism where it's not a woman, it's not a man. Did you think that, Mr. Hector?
Yeah.
Right, yeah. So, okay. All right, so first, this is something from a Japanese man, okay? He wanted to recreate his childhood excitement capturing insects. So, are Pokemon insects?
Some of them are.
Okay.
Some of them are.
What is that yellow thing? I don't know an insect.
Pikachu is like, wasn't he like a mouse?
The mouse?
Pikachu's a mouse because Raichu is like the evolved form and it's a mouse.
Water? Okay. Yeah. All right, so originally you guys, your generation, you had 151 Pokemons, right?
I remember all this shit.
Isn't there more than 151 now? There's way
more. Oh, yeah.
There's 1,000 now. So are you guys, I don't want to say, are you guys old school Pokemon and the new people, or?
I think it varies.
It varies?
I think she has a question in the back. She has a question in the back.
Yes. No. In their belief system, in their like Buddhism, Hinduism, they actually do have deities that are non-gender, actually. They're not man or not woman. Kind of like Shiva, you know, like they have both or none, okay? No. It's a belief system, okay? All right, so if you don't know, especially anthropologist majors, Pokemon is actually banned in lots of Catholic schools and Christian schools, right? Because it's a specific belief, a kind of a Japanese cultural belief. But why would it be banned, guys? Because it is banned, just like Harry Potter. Mr. Angel, yes. Right. It promotes animal cruelty? Do you guys believe that?
You're cruel. I could see how that would happen. Yeah,
okay.
They're fighting each other to
All right, Mr. Angel, let's even go deeper. What about it? Did you have a Pokemon back in the day?
Yeah.
All right. Did you fight with it? What did you do?
Yeah.
You play the game? Okay. So does it change? Does the Pokemon's change? All right. Yeah. So tell me how it changes. I'm going to give you mine. How does it change? Well, that's the answer.
Certain Pokemon, after a certain level, they evolve. Pokemon, after you trade them, they evolve. Or certain Pokemon, when you give them a stone, they evolve.
Oh, wow. That's fighting words you're saying. That's banned in Christian schools. Okay, in Catholic schools. Right, guys? What Mr. Angel said is it's evolution, guys. And Japanese people do actually believe in evolution. So write that down. That's really, again, a Japanese belief system, right? They do believe in evolution. Guys, that's like one of the most controversial things in the U.S. now, right? One of them, right? Evolution, right? So that's why it's banned, right? As well as Harry Potter. Harry Potter is also banned, okay? All right, Pokemon, okay? I've never played with it because I'm like the G.I. Joe Transformers generation. You guys were like, I want you guys to think about Pokemon, okay? Because it was like my little cousins were into it. Now they're like 22. I always thought when I was high school and I would see them play like in elementary, like, you're being suckered. Isn't it you have to buy it? You buy it, and then, Mr. Angel, don't you have to keep buying? After they evolve,
you trade too. After you beat people, you get their cards. I
mean, but you still keep buying, though.
Well, if you're good, you don't have to.
Do you not see the suckerization, Mr.
But
Chris?
That's everything in this society. It's kind of like, it's everything. I don't know. That could be debatable.
Okay, but you still have to buy and buy, right? No?
You don't have to keep buying. I mean, like, you can stop at, like, say, Diamond and not play.
Yeah, but pretty much.
Are there not people who keep buying, though?
You don't have to. It depends on the individual. You could stop when you want to.
Okay.
It's like an addiction.
It's kind of like Barbie. You buy one, but Pokemon, don't you keep buying? Okay. All right.
Miss
Nelly, here, read it.
Pokemon is a game of strategy, skill, perseverance, training, and knowledge. And the play activities it is said to promote include collecting, competition, pet raising, mastery, adventures, and role-playing. Goal? Fill in the blank. World's greatest Pokemon master. Was that the good one?
Excellent. Thank you. Wonderful reader. Guys, again, I've never played this. So, Mr. Ranger, what is the goal? Mr. Ranger, what's the goal of Pokemon?
Oh, well,
to defeat others.
Defeat others.
Bam. Become a master trainer.
Yeah.
Collect them all. Do you don't see how that is buying?
Yeah.
Exactly, promoting consumerism.
Yeah.
So,
well, at right. the same time, capitalism. It also promotes the system of reward, the capital reward.
Because,
like, if you get more, you're kind of, like, seen as a higher status of, like, almost master trainer kind of thing.
So it's hierarchical?
Kind of. Depending, like, if you play against someone that's, like, a really sore winner kind of thing.
In the game, whenever you meet up with Professor Oak, okay. He
always
tells you,
like,
go collect more Pokemon. I'm not really feeling how many you have right
now. Oh, wow. Wow, okay.
That's a TV show, too. Like, he has to keep going.
You guys don't see how it makes you buy?
No, we see that, right. But it's kind of like that wasn't the main thing about Pokemon.
True, but... Okay, success. So please write that, guys. I think you guys already know this, but it's collecting, competition, pet raising, mastery, adventure, role-playing. As Mr. Benjamin said, capitalism. It mimics capitalism, right? Let's flip it over. Mr. Angel, Mr. Benjamin, what if, can't we just have it all equal? Can't you have two each of the same exact one?
Well, then it would be as competitive. I think competition also promotes, like, this kind of sense of, like...
Does it have to be competitive? Can it be the same?
Well, it's not like they just make one card. It's not like they just make, like, one card of everything. Like, there's, like, hundreds of cards of each person.
But,
yeah.
Okay, so can we have socialism kind of same?
No, there's no denying. All right, go ahead. There's no denying of anything here.
Okay. Where's the other one? Where's the other?
It's okay. So, I don't know where the other one is, but what were you talking about? Oh yeah, can it be socialism? No, because it's about competition. I mean, even if you go back to like Roman times when they had like gladiators fighting and the like chariot racing, we tend to value or kind of thrive off of like the idea of like either, you know, battling or violence or competition. And even in the economy and stuff like that, even small businesses and stuff like that, like our whole system is kind of based off of a somewhat of a competition. Okay. In the 1970s, when Japan began experiencing the comforts of recovery in a story called Dario Mom began serialization in Boys Comic Magazine. Pokemon comes out later. Who is Doraemon?
All right, guys. Does anyone know who this is? Raise your hand if you know Doraemon. How do you know Doraemon?
Well, I read a lot of history about it, and I feel like Digimon, which is a huge show, and Digimon, all the monsters, digital monsters, all their names end with mons like this, and they have like a Digimon named Doraemon, actually. And I feel like Pokemon took off of Digimon, but was more successful in America.
Because it was more cutesy in it, too.
Yeah. You don't know what Digimon is? Okay, Digimon is basically the same concept as Pokemon, but rather than collecting a whole bunch of Digimon, it's about establishing a relationship.
They don't die.
Okay.
Yeah. And they like try to save the world kind of thing.
Okay.
They actually can talk, like, speak your language, so they don't just say, like, pika pika.
Okay.
You establish a relationship, so it's more of a friendship and your friends fighting for you.
Okay.
Than, like, grabbing six slaves.
And you can evolve anytime you want.
And you can evolve? Okay. Do you have to beat someone to evolve?
No.
It's like a power of friendship, kind of save the day kind of thing.
Okay. All right.
It's kind of cool.
All right. So, guys, other than Mr. Benjamin said he's an anime beep, okay? How do you guys know about Doraemon? Because Doraemon was a failure in the U.S. Japan tried to make it popular. It was not popular. So how do you guys know about it? So you watch Japanese anime, and that's how you know. But you didn't get it in the U.S. I mean, some weird, because they tried it. It wasn't successful. Okay, great.
Or, like, I know that back in my hometown, I started getting kind of exposed to anime, too, and that's how I found out about it. And, like, they would literally have, like, either, like, DVDs with, like, either subtitles or old, like, VHSs of certain, like, 80s anime and stuff like that.
Okay. Excellent. Okay. All right. Who knows this gentleman? Or, actually, yeah, he's now older. But who knows this guy? He is the number one Pokemon collector in the world. Okay. He's got tons, and if you actually went back around him, it's all Pokemon, right? He's like world famous for collecting all the Pokemons like ever made. Okay. He's actually kind of famous within the Pokemon worlds. Okay, so, all right, so there are people like you, your generation. He's probably your generation, okay? All right, so can someone read it?
I was raised on Pokemon.
Okay. So were you guys raised on it?
Yeah.
Okay. So you're a bond with Pokemon collecting, evolution, Mr. Angel, also capitalism. Okay. All right. Children are also described. Can someone read it?
Children also describe their play with Pokemon in the same terms. Raise pocket monsters by developing their strengths over time. Children would then speak far more instrumentally, calling their wards weapons and tools used in a playscape premised on capture. Were you raised on Pokemon?
Wrong, the other way. Were you raised on? Guys, did you use it as a way to, I don't know, hierarchical oppress another kid in elementary school?
Yeah.
Okay. Pass her the mic. Tell us about your oppression of other third graders.
Well, I mean, this is just like kind of like elementary school. You kind of like, I don't know, like this is just my experience because like I was like the smart ass kid in elementary school. Everybody tried to beat me up. But like, here's okay. The thing though, like even with Pokemon or like Yu-Gi-Oh, whatever card game you want, you try to beat the other kid because you want that card. Like,
okay.
Yeah, you try to get all the cards. I remember I tried playing because I wanted Pikachu. I couldn't find Pikachu anywhere, so I just wanted to play for the Pikachu.
Okay.
It was a rare card, right? Like, well, I don't understand. Like, Pikachu was like the big face, and then I couldn't find any freaking
Pass
Pikachu.
Pass it back that way. Did you guys feel bad if you didn't, if you lost?
Oh, if you lost.
Yeah. Oh, you did?
Yeah, you would.
Tell us your bad experience. Like, why would it make you feel anything?
Well, like, the worst moment I ever had with Pokemon was I got the holographic Mew card for my birthday. And then, so basically I was like, really awesome because I had that card, but then I lost it and I just have really never gotten over it.
Wow. Thank you for sharing. Thank you. Okay. Yes.
I think with my experience back in like elementary school and middle school, you would have the group of friends that played Pokemon. And if you knew something that they didn't, they would come to you to spread that knowledge of how to get a Pokemon.
So
where to get it or what
hierarchy.
To do. Yeah.
Thank you. I didn't know. Okay. You feel bad about it. You have knowledge. Okay. So, guys, so this is go ahead.
Like, it was like that in my elementary school, too, because we would bring Game Boys to elementary school. And, like, if you had, like, a Pokemon that was, like, level 100 or you had a fossil Pokemon, you were, like, a badass in the school.
Wow. So, were you rich? Because how come you could afford a Game Boy?
I actually got it, like, in 2000.
So,
I was probably, like, 10 when I got a Game Boy.
Is it rich people have Game Boys? Like, what?
No. They're affordable later on.
Okay.
Yeah,
you had color, you're rich.
It's color? Okay. So you guys were rich kids?
They were like 70. Hello? No, Game Boys were cheap. They were like 70 bucks.
It's not cheap.
No, like that would be like my like Christmas present. Like, I waited all year to get a Game Boy. Well. But what I was going to say, they actually came out with a way to, like, play each other on Game Boys for Pokemon. And, like, you could, like, battle your friends at school. And that was, like, probably the most upsetting thing. Because if you lost, you'd be really mad.
Okay.
Professor Banh.
Is anyone in this class not into Pokemon and they're just, like, weirded out by the whole, well, you're in elementary and the Pokemon fiends around you? You're like, ugh. Anyone? Let's have a hand of people not into. Okay, yes. Someone said so sorry for you.
Thank you. So yeah, I didn't understand why that was. I thought it was because it was like boyish, or I didn't know if it was like violent. I never watched it, so I just trusted my mom, who also didn't let me eat from ice cream trucks, but that's other childhood issues. Yeah. So yeah, I'm really confused about this whole conversation.
So it's like a class of obsessed, and then one or two their parents didn't let them. Anyone else back there? Yes, Mr. Andrew, go ahead.
Can you guys hear? Okay. I think that there's like this sense of classism when it comes to Pokemon trading cards or anything that involves like kind of infecting a generation. Like, even if we look at the iPhone, like, you have the 5C and then the 5S, and it's like, if you have an S, there's a there's a more social equity to that. And then you have holographic cards that like kind of gave you a social equity with Pokemon cards too. Like I could have a Pikachu, then somebody could bring out a holographic Pikachu and it's like, whoa, where'd you get that?
You're bringing up memories. Okay. All right, you're bringing up memories here. Okay. All right, Mr. Ranger, can you read it? And guys, this is a 6-year-old woman writing about your childhood fantasies, and do you agree with her actual thesis? So can you read it, Mr. Benjamin?
Marketed Pokemon, cuteness and playfulness across the human, non-human border. Flexible across the human and non-human border.
All right. So guys, is this true? Is this why you liked it? It doesn't really look human to me, but it doesn't look like animal to me either. So what is it? Imagination, imaginary.
I was younger, I was very imaginative, still kind of am.
And, okay.
That's one of the reasons why I got into Pokemon, and I also got into Digimon and all these other different shows, is because it kind of presented a different alternate reality that was just kind of, it seemed more awesome than what I was going through at the time.
Interesting. Great. Yes.
There's also like the emphasis on like the hero and like, you know, like everybody Team Rocket, like the villain versus the hero thing.
That okay.
Was awesome. Like, to come home to watch it is like,
really? Okay. Yeah. Who knew? Okay, Mr. Angel, yes. Human, what are the human qualities?
Like with Pikachu, you could see when he gets mad or tired or hungry or okay. They needed to go to the hospital or they cried okay. together. Stuff like
he
that.
Had to go
like,
to the hospital?
Yeah, like they had to go to the Pokemon Center.
Is it chubby? Like you like the chubbiness of it? It's
no,
cute. Just, yellow?
Not that one particularly. Cute. That's not my favorite. But
okay. Is this your generation or?
Well, I know more generations than just the first one. I was raised on the first one, but I know more than just the first one.
Okay. Oh, wow. We have fiends and confused people who were not allowed. Okay. All right. So please write down the reason why it was popular. This author argues is that it's cute, it's flexible, and it's not human or human. It's like between the borders, right? So again, about gender, because it's like not gendered at all. Again, like not even human, right? So it goes beyond that. All right. Can someone read it?
I'll read it. More than one dozen editions of the Pokemon Game Boy number 2 game, the latest Emerald, came out in 2005, increasing the number of Pokemon more than 300. Actually, the latest version was not Emerald. It's, what is it?
What black is it?
White. It's black and white now.
Wow. How many?
There's like 7, 6.
700 or 7,000?
Oh, 700 Pokemon. Around
wow.
That
okay.
Multiple e-media arena and merchandise merchandising opportunities. Oh, okay. Been a huge industry marketed in various forms, then 140 countries and producing global profits of more than 15 billion by August 2003.
Sorry, sometimes dog not looks that way. All right, guys. So it's huge, guys. It's all over the world huge, right? So if you go to Thailand, you go to Nigeria, you go to Chile, you're going to meet people who are into Pokemon just like you, okay? But again, it is Japanese cultural imagination. Also gender, because it's between human and non-human, okay? So whatever gender it is between or no gender, okay? So again, this is important to talk about because it's like a billion-dollar industry, right? A global billion-dollar industry that represents Japanese cultural imagination. And I really want to emphasize that China has repeatedly, again and again, tried to market its own kind of like cartoons, right? And its own kind of like boy bands. But you guys don't like it. It has failed, okay? And they always wonder, why is Pokemon popular? Why is like K-pop popular? But why isn't Chinese products popular, right? So this is a huge issue, guys. Huge, okay?
Is there an answer yet?
We don't know. Okay. We don't know. There's probably multiple answers. All right. Pokemon equals capitalism. Can someone read it?
I'll read it.
Yes.
Pokemon equals capitalism. The game is continual acquisition. The objects one gets are both thingified, valued economically, and personalized. Cute monsters inspiring affection, attachment, and love. The logic of play here involves a currency of shifting and multiple valences between spirits and profits, companions and capital, inalienable and alienable goods. Capitalism is thus equally mimicked. Do you agree?
Do you agree, yes or no? It's capitalism. So you guys were little capitalists at 7 years old. Okay. Indoctrinated at 7, right? Okay, so that makes it even more important, right? You have like this background, okay? All right, we're not doing that one, okay? All right, let's move on. Raise your hand if you heard of something called Sailor Moon. All right. You need to help me, okay? Sailor Moon, is this your theme song? And just tell me, do you want the Japanese version? You need to tell me. I don't know. Just you tell me. Okay, which one? This one?
Sailor Moon.
This one? Okay. All right. Raise your hand if you're a gentleman that you were also raised on Pokemon. If you're a male that was raised on Internet. Okay, so women, you all were as well? Okay. Is this Sailor Moon?
Fighting evil by moonlight, winning love by daylight. Never run from a real fight. She is the one named Sailor Moon. She will never turn it on your friend. She is always there to see you there. She is the one of whom we can defend. She is the one that is Sailor. Sailor Venus, Sailor Mercury, Sailor Mars, Sailor Jupiter.
Break down Sailor Moon for me. Break it down. Okay, break it down. Break it down. Someone give her the mic. So pass it down. Tell me the beginning, end, and how old were you when you watched?
Oh my gosh. in elementary school. So I want to say, like 9 or 10 when I was first watched it, or when I first saw it on TV. And it's basically about these girls or these students, and they're all representation of a planet, so they're called Sailor Scouts. Okay. I've seen Dragon Ball Z too. And, oh my gosh, the plotline gets kind of crazy, but basically the representations, and they derive like their power from like the stars and the planets, and they come to save the day, and they have really, really, really long like transformation scenes that are just repeated animation, but it's great.
And did you notice they don't wear that much clothes?
Of course. And also that they're only supposed to be like high school girls. And I think that can go back to kind of like maybe a, you know, Japanese fetish. Or even like, I know that even in America we might have a fetish for like schoolgirl uniforms kind of thing. But yeah.
Thank you. Did you think that when you're a kid?
I actually didn't think too much about that. I was just like, okay. Oh, look how pretty they look. And they're fighting the bad guys. And look, they have superpowers. Pew.
All right, this is why you guys are the awesome generation, because remember, like, I was raised on crappy like Barbie and also Disney. So Ms. Ashley can tell me why, you know, add something to that, because you guys were raised on really powerful women.
At first, when I was a kid, I didn't realize that they were wearing so less clothes until now that I watched it again, and their skirts are very short. But I like Sailor Moon because as a kid, I don't know if this makes me a nerd, but I learned my solar system when I was like 5. Yeah, because of all the planets and everything. Yeah. Yeah.
Excellent. Thank you. Okay, so it's educational, okay? All right, anything else, Sailor Moon fiends? Okay, pass it back.
I'm gonna be honest here that I did like Sailor Moon, but the thing is, like, I'm pretty sure most of us guys stayed and watched Sailor Moon because we wanted to watch Dragon Ball Z afterwards, I guess.
Is that true?
I liked it, though. I learned to like it, though, but I just want to admit that that's how I got into it. So it's kind of like, to me, those two are kind of like the two most memorable ones that most of us can, I guess, kind of think at the top of our head.
So you only watched it because something Dragon Ball Z was after.
Well, yeah, but then I liked it too, and I was a little kid, so at that time I was like, oh, this is girl. I wasn't like, oh, this is girl. I was like, oh, look, it's another cartoon, because back then, like, you know, us kids, we didn't really know the difference between
gender,
that, and we didn't know the difference between cartoon and anime, so it just really, really didn't matter.
Okay, excellent. All right, pass it.
Oh, I don't even need it.
Okay. Oh, never mind.
As a kid, and I'll keep it real, she'll keep it 100. really like the transformation scenes as a boy.
What is this?
Basically, what are you talking about? They get like kind of like nude, like, but like no nipples.
Wait
or
a
like.
Can you just show a transformation scene?
And like talking about transformation scene, another thing that I thought I'd bring up talking about gender is in the English version, there's these two Sailor Scouts that are called cousins, but in the Japanese version, they're actually lesbians. But in the.
Right.
There's Sailor Uranus and Sailor Neptune.
Is it? Which one?
The first one.
Okay. International students, do you know what they're talking about in any way? Any of you guys, Ms. Rami? Did you watch Sailor Moon? Who has not watched Sailor Moon before? So you just think they're weird, right? But they're obsessed. They're obsessed people.
Dude.
Okay.
No, all right. Moon, Fitty, makeup!
And then that happens for all of the other Sailor Scouts, pretty much.
Okay, so Miss Ashley, this is your childhood? Okay. All right. Can you read it? Yes.
Okay. Fierce flesh, sexy schoolgirls in the action packed of Sailor Moon. 1993, Sailor Moon debuts. 94, Mighty Morphin Power Range. I remember that too. What?
My other class, but okay. Not this one.
So 300 million of toy franchise. 95, heralds three more Japanese shows, Dragon Ball Z, Masked Rider, Raymond Kata, Sailor Moon, cartoon and girls version of Power Rangers.
So did you guys also like Power Rangers?
I also liked Power Rangers.
Okay. So again, this is all Japanese gender, you know, imagination, right? It's cultural. So please write this down, okay? All together, right? All right. So again, Sailor Moon comes out in 93, and it's a huge hit, okay? So that the fact that everyone knows, except for some people over here, they don't, never heard of it. Okay. Yes, Mr. Major.
Yeah, that's true. Like, I've always wondered, like, if anybody had a theory on why the Pink Ranger was, like...
Wasn't it, like, gender neutrality? Because, like, even when babies are born, like, it's something some moms choose, like, a yellow kind of, like, room instead of a blue and a pink, like, you know, for the gender.
Yeah, but the Yellow Ranger was still a female, and she didn't have a
sister. Yeah.
I don't know about that. I thought of originally, like, one thing about Power Rangers, too, or I don't know, it's been discussed about for, like, the older version, is how it's kind of, like, I don't know, like, kind of racist in a sense, because, like, you had, like, Yeah, Asian was yellow, black ranger was black. Yes. You know, the white female ranger was pink. It was just...
Yes. Can you read that?
Okay, 92 to 97, Sailor Moon in Japan, 200 episodes. There had been female fighters, a tradition in animation. Tekio Naoko was a young manga writer when her work caught, called Nao Yoshi, and a klutzy female crime fight caught on.
All right, guys, so write that down. Naoko is the originator of Sailor Moon, and I want you guys to think deeply about this. This really goes against the Disney canon, right? Think of Disney, she's sleeping fully in the film and then a kiss, right? But these are fighting people, guys. So you guys, you really don't know, but the millennial generation are raised on fighting women, right? That's huge. That's actually huge, right? That's a big effect on you, right? The other generations didn't have. They didn't have that. It was like woman at home or waiting to be kissed or something. Okay. All right. All right. Yes. Yes. What? Okay, that's a great question. Actually, they're influenced by Disney. So they're like really the original animators really like Mickey Mouse's big eyes. So they're actually supposed to be like Mickey Mouse's. Like, it's kind of human, but not, you know, like a gender out, like non-human, kind of, but near Disneyland.
Do you know Dragon Ball Z and Dare to that?
Yes.
Okay, like, the main character, as a normal person, he's more Japanese, and he has black hair, he has black eyes.
Right.
And then when he becomes a Super Saiyan, which is, like, his powerful form,
blonde hair.
Again, I original Japanese animation is influenced by Disney, actually. All the original, there's actually books on this. Disney had pushed their comics first into Japan. So it's an interpretation of a Disney comic.
Or yeah. I have an idea even, but I don't know if it comes from everywhere. But I know like Japan was one of the first countries or Asian countries to actually imperialize other countries, whereas other European powers were doing the same thing. So maybe it's kind of linked to like that, I don't know, maybe like a status correlation thing. We're like, oh, you know, I don't know.
Could be. And can you read it?
Okay. Yeah. Girls who prefer the video arcade to studying, teenage heroines who transform to fight evil, manga series, cartoon novels like Action, and the Magical Girls.
All right. So it is actually, Sailor Moon is also globally famous, all over the world, 140 countries. It's huge, just huge, just like Power Rangers and Pokemon. Okay, so it is really different, right? She's not a studious girl. She's like, wants to play hooky. Okay, that's one. She's a heroine, but she's also like a fighting heroine. Like, she's not the victim that has to be saved, right? So really going against the Disney canon, right? Really against it. And you guys are so influenced by that positively, right? So you guys don't know that you're kind of stronger than the previous generations in a sense, right? Millennials rock, okay? All right, Mr. Adventure, do you have a comment?
Oh, no, I was explaining the characters.
Okay. Okay. All right. They're magical creatures. All right. Can you read it?
What is confused and also complicated in Sailor Moon is the grammar at work between dreams, sexuality, power, and the ordinary everyday. Thesis. Girls who show off their bodies but are of fierce flesh and as strong as male superhero defies categories of feminism and sexism.
All right, this is huge, guys. Write that thesis down, guys. That's huge. Guys, this is something that it's grappled with constantly in women's studies. Ms. Ashley, I'm going to ask you, can you be strong, intelligent, yet also sexy?
Yeah.
Can Hillary Clinton wear this outfit? Would you vote for her for president? What? Okay, Ms. Allery, you gotta school us. This is huge, right? This is your generation. You can be strong and sexy? Do you want to see Hillary Clinton in a shorts?
I personally think that you should be able to, because no one says anything about guys with their shirts off all day. And there's this one naked guy rolling around. I think he's Ricky Martin's boyfriend or something like that. But no one says anything about them and how they look when they're in power. So I think for women, it's just like, it's like one-sided. We cannot be strong and beautiful and powerful and show cleavage. It just doesn't work. So, right. Right, we have to be conservative, and then even sometimes when we're conservative and then we're powerful, they're like, oh, she's a bitch. Like, exactly. She's not. So, you have to kind of choose. So either, yeah, you can't be pretty and powerful.
That's pretty, that's a really magical fighting word that you just said. You have to choose, right? Do you have to choose? That is huge.
Yeah.
You guys don't know the flack that Hillary Clinton said. She actually got flack for wearing skirts, okay? She has to wear pantsuits for the rest of her life, okay? Because yes, and she does. She shows her calves, and that is not unacceptable, okay? Not me, but that's what Clinton said.
That was actually the topic I wrote for the essay in this class. I compared Hillary Clinton and Sarah Palin just to show the two different sides. But it was also, a lot of the research I did was how Hillary Clinton was seen as basically a bitch and was so manly in her mannerisms. But Sarah Palin, although not strong politically wise, she was known as the national MILF, and that was all that mattered. So, I mean, Sarah Palin was the pretty one who wasn't strong in politics, but Hillary Clinton was the man one. And that's basically how you guys were talking about how there has to be one or the other. But both of them like got unfair media from just like media in general is so sexist against women in politics.
So guys, in your imaginary, you got something that probably we can't have in real life. Maybe in the future, okay? All right, is that 8:30? Yeah. All right, guys, let's do one more hand for the graduating seniors. You're awesome. You're the 1%. You're the 1%. We'll see you next class, and we'll study for the final next class, okay? Yes.
Good luck. My hardest quarter is gonna probably be winter quarter for me, not fall but winter, because I'm doing biochem, physics, and TVNS.
I'm gonna probably die a little. Yeah.
But you know what? That's the major. Oh, look, here's the other mic.
I forgot about that.
So yeah, you found the other mic.
Yep.
I'm gonna go to chemical sciences right now, because I have access to chemical sciences, so I'm gonna go in there and then probably study until like maybe 3 or 4 in the morning. I have class tomorrow's Wednesday. My first class isn't until 11 o'clock.
That's good time.
Yeah, so I can afford to stay up late. Even if I can, I still stay up late.
Dude, I can't wait to watch the rematch.
Are there any questions?